health secretary, my colleagues from the embassy who have been in the forefront of coordinating vaccine cooperation between India and Nepal. They are there. One is Ms. Soumya. Where are you, Soumya?
Yep.
Can you come here? And Mr. Naveen. Honorable Minister has been kind enough to recognize me and thank me for the cooperation. But I want to mention that the people who are actually working behind the scenes in making all this possible is Ms. Soumya, Mr. Naveen, and the rest of my team in embassy. So I thought it important to recognize them. As the Right Honorable Minister mentioned, you, the honorable, respectable people from the media, who actually have been in the forefront of highlighting not just this pandemic, its impact, but also in channelizing the efforts, the positive efforts, in fight against this pandemic, whether those efforts are internal to the country or those efforts are a result of a bilateral cooperation between the two countries. When the pandemic outbreak took place last year, I think from the very first day, various elements of cooperation between India and Nepal to fight this pandemic started. They started because I think very early on, the whole world realized that the fight against COVID-19 is not a fight of one particular nation or one particular society. It has to be a collective fight. It has to be a fight which can be won only if the countries cooperate. Cooperate with only one objective in mind. Cooperate with the objective of benefiting the people, of freeing them from this problem of COVID-19, and hence, as a result, also unleash various other economic forces which have been quite constrained during the pandemic. Keeping this in mind, our cooperation with Nepal started right from the early days of the initial protective equipment to the PCR testing kits, moving to the supply of the ICU ventilators, and also then ending with the remdesivir medicine. The next step, obviously, the most conclusive step in the fight against COVID is the vaccine. And I think the entire global vaccine community, academic community, scientific community, which the minister made a reference to, has been constantly working right from day one of this pandemic outbreak to develop this vaccine. And again, vaccine as a global good, not vaccine as a self-induced individual good, as a global good. I think finally we are seeing very fruitful outcomes of the efforts of the global scientific community in the development of these vaccines all over the world. I am very happy to state that there are successful vaccine development which has taken place in India. Two of the vaccines against the COVID have been developed in India. And as the Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi ji, had said, and I quote, "India's vaccine production and delivery capacity would be used for the benefit of all humanity." It is not, as I said, an effort which is inward-looking. It's an effort which is both for the benefit of our own people, but also for the benefit of the global community, humanity, and in particular our neighbors. As a result of that, and in continuation of our previous cooperation, I'm very happy to confirm what the minister said, that India will provide on grant basis, as a grant, as a gift, 1 million doses of the COVID-19 vaccine. And if all goes well, it should be able to reach in Kathmandu over the next couple of days, subject to flight logistics and other details. We are very happy to announce that. I would also like to mention that when the Honorable Foreign Minister, Shri Pradeep Gyawali ji, visited India last week, one of the important aspects of the discussion between him and his counterpart in India, Dr. S. Jaishankar, the External Affairs Minister of India, was the cooperation relating to COVID. I am very happy to state that within 1 week of those discussions, and I would say a fruitful outcome of those discussions, we feel satisfied that we would be able to bring the vaccine to Nepal. As I mentioned, this vaccine is a gift from the government and people of India to the government and people of Nepal, who I think have been working tirelessly, both in the government structures, but also more at the people level, working tirelessly to fight against this pandemic. I would also like to mention that Nepal would be among the first few countries to receive this vaccine outside India. You would all be familiar that the rollout of the vaccine in India started only on the 16th, which was, I think, Saturday or Sunday. So, a vaccine coming to Nepal within a week of that, roughly, is effectively a parallel, effort, parallel to the effort within India. In my view, the vaccine cooperation between India and Nepal and the arrival of vaccine in Nepal over the next few days signifies three firsts. One, it signifies people first, most important. Two, it signifies friendship first. And three, it signifies neighborhood first. The vaccine itself is also a result of a very strong base of vaccine production in India. I'm sure you're aware roughly 70% of all vaccines in the world are effectively sourced from India for various global supply. In the end, what I will hope is that with this effort, with our joint efforts, it would probably be signaling the beginning of the end of COVID in Nepal. We are happy that we are able to be one of the starting points of the journey towards the end in the joint cooperation. And we look forward to the rollout of an effective vaccination program in Nepal, which puts an end to this pandemic and which puts an end to the suffering of the people and society. With these words, I would like to once again thank the Minister, Mr. Videsh Tripathi ji, for organizing this joint press conference, at which we are happy to share this significant element of our bilateral cooperation with regard to the COVID-19 vaccine coming from India for Nepal. Thank you very much. Thank you.